Sarah Allen. We don't talk about Sarah Allen as we do the rest of them, but we have Sister Carla Winfrey here today, who's going to enlighten us on Sarah Allen.
Good morning, saints. To most, very little is known about me, but I was there. I was there, saints, praying, praising, protecting, and providing. I was a pillar of strength, like a sturdy beam, supporting my husband, Bishop Richard Allen, as he built the African Methodist Episcopal Church. The bishop and the church gave me so much joy. So let me tell you a little about my journey. In 1764, I was born Sarah Bass in Virginia as a slave. I was sent to Philadelphia when I was 8, and I was freed in 1800, and started attending St. George's Methodist Episcopal Church. There, I joined a band of believers, including Richard Allen and his first wife, Flora. She later passed away. Richard Allen was my class leader at St. George, a mainly white church. And I was there at this house of worship when the good white Christian folk got upset. Because of Richard Allen's 5 a.m. sermons, he started drawing crowds. And ironically, blacks were no longer welcome. Too many colored folks. Well, we wanted our own church anyway, to spread the gospel. But St. George's said no. Even though they had licensed Richard Allen and his beloved friend Absalom John Jones in 1784 as lay preachers in the Methodist Church. So, not ones to take no for an answer, the friends joined and they formed another group, the Free African Society. It wasn't a church, but a non-denominational mutual aid society. And it helped members in need. But we did eventually have to meet there for worship. And here's why. It was in 1787, and I was there. On a horrific Sunday, tempers began to fly because the church wanted to segregate black worshipers. The same black membership that helped build the congregation, the same black membership that helped build a new gallery, supposedly, for the entire congregation. But we soon discovered it was going to be a slave gallery. A church officer, named Reverend Jones, up by his collar, pulled him to his feet while he was praying to the Lord God, our Almighty. And Reverend Jones calmly said, "Wait until prayer is over, and I will get up and trouble you no more." The red-faced trustee said, "You must get up now, or I will call aid and force you away." And for a few moments, I had a flashback of being a slave again in bondage. But the black members marched out the door like the great exodus from Egypt to worship in spirit and in truth and in peace.